Hey guys, so today I'm going to be reviewing the classic gangster movie, Goodfellas, directed by Martin Scorsese. We're caught in a trap. I can't walk out. Because I love you too much, baby. With a very special guest. We go to school together, and he knows a lot about movies, and I'm very glad to have him on my movie review today. It is Fernando Guerrero! Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you. I know.
I'm great. Welcome.
All right. Okay, Cal. So we're talking about Goodfellas.
Oh, yes.
How many times did you say you've watched Goodfellas?
I've seen this once.
Okay.
Just once. Ronan has seen it many more than that. It's his favorite movie. It's really iconic movie.
Mm-hmm.
How about you?
I believe I've seen it 3 or 4 times. If there's any movie that I can think of off the top of my head that I would say like a 10 out of 10, it would have to be Goodfellas. I mean, the cinematography, the soundtrack, the actors, the plot, the fact that it was relatively based off a true story. And then at the end, it doesn't glorify the gangster life. You know, it shows the reality of what happens, destroys families, and, you know, it was just terrible how it went in the end, but...
Exactly.
Yeah, it was one of my, definitely my top 5 favorite movies of all time. Do you have a favorite scene in Goodfellas?
Favorite scene? Well, everyone, the opening is unreal.
As far back as I can remember, I've always wanted to be a gangster. Bum, 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 with the red light.
As far back as I can remember, I always wanted to be a gangster.
I know I'd go from rags to riches.
I don't know how Scorsese thought of that, but he's a genius for it. Ray Liotta plays Henry Hill.
Yeah.
And then you have his two friends, Joe Pesci and Robert De Niro. That's an insane cast. And then even like the supporting performances, though, are unreal as well.
So, I mean, the first time you're watching that and you see the bump in the back of the car, you're like, this is serious. You know this is serious.
Well, you don't know what's going on, and then all of a sudden they start like shooting and stabbing the guy, and then you're like, oh, it's that movie.
It shows the brutality right away. It really goes to it. And so it shows the brutality, and then it shows his childhood, which I think is a really interesting dynamic, how it goes from such a brutal scene to when he was just a kid, and it shows how he was basically indoctrinated into the mafia from such a young age. I mean, it was in the neighborhood. He talks about seeing the people, and I mean, like the opening line said, he always wanted to be a gangster. He idolized the gangsters. The gangsters were the good people, and were good people in the community to be looked up to a certain extent. And if you watch The Sopranos, if you watched other gangster shows, or even just the real life history, you know that without security cameras, I mean, there was just so much more corruption back then.
Yeah.
So it definitely was better. If you're going to be a gangster, it was better to be a gangster back then.
Oof, Maron.
Multiple other actors from Goodfellas ended up in The Sopranos. For example, Michael Imperioli and Lorraine Bracco. I'd say it really started when he was influenced by Robert De Niro's character.
Mm-hmm.
He was like working by the restaurant, and then suddenly Robert De Niro stuffing everyone's pockets full of cash, including him, for doing like nothing. So that just like gives him a taste, kind of what it's like. And then they show the shots of him like blowing up a bunch of taxis.
Yeah, that was the first major thing, and then when he didn't rat on the people, because I believe that was an insurance fraud sort of situation. I might be wrong about that, but
he got pinched, as they say.
Yeah, exactly. But he didn't, like they said, the number one rule, he didn't get everybody out, and he gave him some money for that, and that was a big lesson.
I mean, the scene when he's going in the back of the Copa, it's like the tracking shot of him and Lorraine Bracco. They're gonna go in the front, and then it's like, oh, we have no seats. And then he's like, I'll go in the back.
I like going this way better than waiting in line.
And in reality, it was because Martin Scorsese couldn't get the rights to shoot at the front of the Copa, like the real Copacabana. So instead, they went in the back and created one of the most memorable shots. It's like Henry Hill going in back with this lady and pressing her. mm-hmm. introducing all these people.
You're talking about when they walk through the back alley entrance? Like, when, yeah. they, when they open that door? Yeah,
exactly.
That
and then,
incredible.
And then they, like, pull in a random table for yeah. them in the middle of everyone.
Well, it shows. Money talks, and back then, being a gangster, definitely, like, he talks about in the movie, there was a lifestyle to it. And at the end of the movie, he talks about he couldn't even get spaghetti. And, I mean, then he was treated like a king to an extent. The other people waited in line. He skipped the line. Other people can't get a table. He got a table. So, I mean, you almost, if you're watching it for the first time without really too much of an understanding, you might think to yourself, you know, I want to be a gangster. I mean, it impresses his lady, his girlfriend at the time. She's obviously impressed about his gangster attitude. She was attracted to that.
Mm-hmm.
So it just, in that way, it glorifies it to an extent, but obviously in the end.
But then you watch the rest of the movie and then you...
Their relationship is so toxic. It's so terrible.
Gotta say, one of the parts that makes this movie so iconic is the voiceover.
Yeah.
Like, it starts in the first scene, and then it continues in the whole movie, and especially, do you remember that part when he's going, I think it was the restaurant or the bar, he's mm-hmm. going in, and he's, like, introducing all these random people,
yeah.
but for some reason, I've always remembered that scene, especially when he's like, that's Tommy Two Times.
Yeah. And Jimmy Two Times, who got that nickname because he said everything twice, like...
I'm gonna go get the papers.
But yeah, the thing about the voiceover, it's Henry Hill reflecting on everything that happened.
Mm-hmm.
So that's one of the reasons why it's so interesting. It's mm-hmm. like him thinking about what happened, you know, could his life have been different or...
Then the scene cut from that to a pretty bad scene of he's standing in the parking lot smoking a cigarette, you know, looking really slick, grown up. So to some extent, I do agree with you that everyone is a product of the environment, but it does show when he was a kid, he talks about how there were other kids in the neighborhood who were jealous of him to an extent and envied him. Because he was able, you know, he didn't have a license. He was driving cars around. He was skipping school all the time. He was doing a variety of things that, and he wasn't forced into any of those things to any extent. You could argue that once he was in it, for a certain period of time, they did kind of rely on him to an extent. And so at that point, you could make a good argument that if he was negligent getting into it. But I think he knew what he was doing. I think he was more than aware of the people he was living around, of their mm-hmm. lifestyles. I mean, he even showed it earlier in the movie. It's his father beat him for hanging out with them and ditching school, but yet he still went back to it. For a character trait, I'd say maybe it's he didn't learn from his mistakes. I mean, he was messing around with the wrong people, and he should have got out of that. I mean, think about how much time he did in prison. What was that one stint when his kids were young, and he was away for 7 or 8 years, I believe, mm-hmm. while your kids are young? I mean, that must have been terrible. Like she said, the mob, you know, they weren't financially supporting him. So, I mean, but then when he got out, he went right back to work for them, for Robert De Niro's character. The way, just to note, the way that they were living in the prison was not realistic at all. The whole private cells they had uh-huh. and everything, yeah, as cool as it seems, all the gangsters who have come out and talked about their time in prison, that was, they had some perks to an extent, right? People knew who they were respected, but there wasn't a private cell where they were cooking spaghetti sauce every night and bringing in
probably wine. Using the little razor blade to cut
that onions. Wasn't happening. That was a Hollywood movie liberty, once again, to kind of make it look good. Yeah, like you said, you know, even when we were in prison, we had things different. So it's true to an extent, but extremely over exaggerated in that scene.
This was nominated for Best Picture. Joe Pesci won Best Supporting Actor for it. He went up and his speech was literally, "The pleasure's all mine," or something like that, and then he walked away.
Joe Pesci in Goodfellas.
It's my privilege. Thank you.
Rather than this movie winning, Dances with Wolves won. And Ronan actually gets really mad about that. So,
Well, I love Dances with Wolves. That's same. Also one of my top 10. I believe the Academy probably gave it to them. Off the top of my head, my assumption would be just the drama in it. Not that Goodfellas isn't full of dramas, but the... just.
Well, that story wasn't told very often, like Native American.
That's an extremely good point from the Native American's perspective. But what I was gonna say, the scenery in it, this the idea of the West. I mean, the Hollywood Wild West might be the biggest, historically the biggest category of all time, you could argue too. I think Kevin Costner, right? Mm-hmm. He was just fantastic in that. And yeah, I mean, I guess you make a great point that maybe it was, or definitely to an extent, that the representation, the positive representation of Native Americans in the movie, I think that might have been, or was extremely appreciated by the Academy compared to Goodfellas, where they're murdering people every couple minutes and things. Not exactly the most family-friendly movie. Not that Dances with Wolves was the most family-friendly movie either.
Some people got scalped in that movie.
Yeah, I'd say that's probably a PG-13 movie. I'd put that about there. I let my little kid watch it. I'd be probably a terrible parent. But,
But yeah, they ended up... Scorsese won Best Picture for The Departed. And they say that was kind of like a lifetime achievement thing. Because he's made so many good movies, and that happened to be the one they chose because of the other movies that year weren't as good, you know? Sometimes it's like, which movie is more important versus which movie is the best? It's tough.
Who knows
what
who?
To choose.
Who knows who? I think that's what I'll say. I love Goodfellas, though. Goodfellas is an incredible
great movie.
If you haven't seen Goodfellas, you got to go out and watch it right now. Or, I mean, I don't know what you're doing with your life if you haven't seen Goodfellas, really.
Exactly. Good point. Romance, one of the greatest movies of all time.
Movie, but I mean, there's romance. Yeah, obviously a big part. But what other categories could you put it in? I mean, I think definitely
crime, drama, romance.
Crime, drama, romance.
Sometimes comedy.
Yeah. Oh, it's totally. Well, that's totally the dramatic effect. I mean, we didn't even talk about. You think I'm a funny guy? I screwed with people. The
funny
times.
How?
Yeah. Yeah.
But like a clown, do I amuse you? That was an improv scene. Joe Pesci improv.
That was all improv.
Improv. That's
not, yeah.
He's a big boy. He knows what he said. What'd you say?
You're right.
Funny how?
Get the out of here, Tommy.
Yeah, I went for $7,000 they charge.
You really are a funny guy.
My favorite part, maybe in the whole movie, might be when they go to get a shovel from his grandma, from
that
his mother's house.
That is the
house.
Greatest scene.
Just keep quiet. I don't want to wake her up. Man. Oh, hey.
Yeah, look who's here.
Hey, what are you doing? What happened?
No, nothing.
What happened to you?
I hit something on the road. Jimmy, yeah.
What happened?
How are you?
I haven't seen you so long. What happened for you?
I hate to see him that way. You too. How are you?
What happened?
I mean, that scene was just incredible. And then with the picture, and they're talking about the dogs, and he's like, look at the way the two dogs.
I don't know. I don't think it looks real.
Look at this.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
I like this one. The dog, one dog goes one way, and the other dog goes the other way.
One is going east, and the other one is going west. So what?
And this guy's saying, what do you want from me? Guy's got a nice head of white hair. Look how beautiful with the dog. It looks the same.
Yeah, and then she's like, Henry, you don't talk much. You're like so-and-so from my village. And she tells the story, and she says how it sounds better in Italian. That scene might have been improv. It sounds so natural, so real. That?
So she says to him, shut up, you're always talking. But in Italian, it sounds much nicer.
Who
knew
the content?
Yeah, that's it.
What's that mean?
That lady is Martin Scorsese's mom.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah,
that's incredible.
I've heard that those scenes with her were all improv.
I would believe it.
She's unreal.
Yeah, with the knife, he was like, oh, we're going to need this. Ha, 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 ha. And then she's like, oh, just make sure you bring it back. He's like, oh, we'll bring it back, all right. Yeah, we decided, I'm going to need to take the shovel, too. Okay. I don't see you anymore. She was like, why don't you get a woman? He's like, oh, I get a woman for a night. Then I get another one the next day. I have you. So that's a great scene.
They leave at like 3 a.m. after she made dinner for them, like 1.
Yeah.
So.
A wonderful woman. She deserved a better son. She deserved a better son than him. She did not deserve Joe Pesci.
Well, I think that about sums it up, everybody. So once again, if you haven't already seen Goodfellas, you should really see it, especially if you're a fan of movies. If you want to see a good movie, it's a guarantee. So, Fernando.
Thank you. thank you for having me on, Cal. It's awesome. I love Goodfellas. Go watch Goodfellas. It's a great movie. You won't regret it. And thank you for having me on the show. I really had a great time.
Thanks a lot for coming. I had a really good time, too. All right, guys. See you all next week, and please subscribe.
Subscribe, or else you I mean, why wouldn't you subscribe? I mean, you should really subscribe. He's probably going to cut this out. But, I mean, you should subscribe.
I won't cut this out.
You should subscribe. I mean, you're going to watch the videos, but you're not going to subscribe. I mean,
keep going.
Support the content. Subscribe. I mean, you really want to support the content. Cal's making these incredible videos. He's doing it all, you know, to help the audience. He really cares about the audience. And I don't think a lot of people have any understanding of how much editing it takes. I mean, we've sat down for probably about 20 minutes to a half an hour now. I know Cal's going to be working on this for at least 2 hours. So,
yeah, probably
I mean,
more.
The least, it just takes 1 second to describe and like, and it really means a big deal. So Cal and I would extremely appreciate it. So thank you. Bottle, 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 bottle.